डॉक्टर साहब प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ।
रवि अनम्यूट डॉक्टर साहब। लेट मी डू दैट। फाइन।
Why can't I see doctor sir? Where is he?
Is there?
His video is off.
No, no, he's there. I can see.
Okay, okay. Lovely, lovely. Doctor sir, namaskar.
Namaskar.
Doctor sir, namaskar.
Namaskar.
Kya hua Nachir? How are you doing, sir?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good, sir. Do you remember our last session we had last Saturday?
Yeah, it was a nice session.
You enjoyed.
How you was enjoyed? Your response?
Oh, excellent. I enjoyed the session. I think your bandwidth.
I really enjoyed the session. My bandwidth?
Yes, now it's better. It's going and coming. I mean, it's okay. We can't help it at this time, you know.
So if you feel it's less, you tell me. How is it now?
Yeah, it's okay. Mono check to kom beshi hobe, but we'll manage.
So I have three connections, so I can change in between.
Yeah, okay. So we had a great session last time. Huh? You enjoyed.
Oh, I loved it. It was a great session.
The idea was to bring all doctors together for an entertainment program where we make them laugh, have jokes, have fun. So we plan to do it again this Saturday with another set of doctors. Another five doctors.
That's a very good idea, actually.
Yes, it's working well. In fact, we'll have a discussion with Jimmy Tangri again today.
Okay.
He's available, then he'll take over again on Saturday.
Oh, he did a great job.
Yeah, he did a good job. In fact, we'll have five doctors at the stage, but you can always join in and have fun too.
Ah, of course, I will. Why not?
Okay.
I would love to be there again.
Yeah, okay. Doctor, we'll start our proceeding because people are waiting here. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, a warm welcome to Papa JC Talk Show and a very good evening to all of you. Yesterday, we had a wonderful session with Dr. Ajay Kumar Arya. अपनी सरल भाषा से उन्होंने बहुतों का मन जीत लिया था कल. Yesterday's session was mind-blowing. Actually, the way he went about talking about breathing and the way to cure the diseases in such a beautiful way that people connected so well. So, Dr. Saab, today you will have to also. I would request you to go on the same lines so that more and more people can connect.
Absolutely.
Okay. That is up. Tomorrow we have an interesting topic. If you can come in, why don't you join? Tomorrow's topic is on parenting.
Ah, that's a lovely topic.
And we have someone from Pune coming in to talk about parenting and the things that one has to face, all relatable and practical issues. And he's talking about parenting of children between, say, 6 and 20, 6 and 22. So it'll be fun. Yeah. Try and come in tomorrow.
I've crossed that stage, I think. 6 Sorry? To 22, I'm still in. 6 to 20, I have crossed.
Okay. This Sunday is Mother's Day. So we've kept a special session. It's called Motherhood is Bliss by Dr. Rajiv Agarwal. And you met him last time he was there.
Yeah, he was on the show.
Yes. So he's talking about Motherhood is Bliss and how to take care of post-delivery or of the child, how to take care of that time, that phase of motherhood. Now, over to you, Kavita ji. Would you please introduce our guest of honor for today?
Yes, my pleasure. So, good evening, everyone. Modern times and our unnatural lifestyles have seen a resurgence of cancer. So, here the role of an oncologist becomes extremely important. So, it's a pleasure to introduce Dr. Shaikat Gupta on board, who is going to have a very light-hearted session with us today. He is one of the topmost cancer surgeons of India, formerly of Tata Memorial Hospital, Mumbai. He He is now the director of cancer surgery at the Apollo Gleneagles Cancer Hospital, Kolkata. He is the representative of entire Eastern India in the 8-member national body of the Indian Association of Surgical Oncology, which is the governing body of cancer surgery in the country. He is the secretary of the Oncological Society of Bengal. Born in Patna in 1968, he received his education in Kolkata. He stood first in MBBS in 1992 and received the gold medal and best thesis award. He completed his MS and FRCS with great honor and awards such as Sir Frank Connor Award, Silver Casket, etc. He also received training in robotic surgery at the Roswell Park Center, Buffalo, USA. He is considered a master in head, neck, breast, intestinal thoracic cancer surgery. He has pioneered ultra-modern techniques of breast cancer surgery in Eastern India, most of which are not done elsewhere. His fraternity knows him for his technique of meticulous bloodless surgery and is famous for his failure rate of 0.1%. He is also the recipient of Lifetime Achievement Award by the Rotary Club. Over to you, Papa JC.
Thank you, Kavita. My goodness, Dr. Sir, you are damn good, yeah?
No.
She's
too kind.
No, but there's so many awards.
Yeah, mil gaya. Chalte mil gaya.
I said, Jaran, Dr. Sir, ask you, what happened today? I received a lot of calls from my regular friend to participate every day.
Okay.
They are saying that the topic is so damn scary, Amak, I don't want to come here. Now, I don't understand why. Is it something called hypochondria here also?
No, there is a general fear about cancer and it is so misplaced. Because cancer today is like any other disease. It's not some... See, there's, whenever there's something scared about a disease, for example, take the coronavirus pandemic right now. A lot of it is unknown. We are scared of the unknown. That is why we are scared of this disease. It is actually a more severe flu. That's what it is, and a more infective one. But because so less is known about it, medicines nahi hai, so that's why people are scared about it. I'm afraid so many years after the disease is about cancer, regarding cancer, so many years after it's been there, it's being treated, so many thousands of patients have become well. There is a general fear in people about cancer. And that is decreasing. I have personally done so many shows on radio, TV, interviews, in forums, etc. But this is a common thing. There is no doubt and no denying that there is a fear about cancer. But that fear is largely misplaced.
Okay,
it's a common disease. It will affect a lot of people we know, and most of them will get cured.
Okay. Like you said that it's a common disease. What do you mean by common disease? Like if it's jaise kisi ko agar appendicitis ho gaya, to jaake wo he goes for an operation.
Yeah.
So would you consider it similar or it's like a different way of looking at it?
Look at it this way. If somebody has an appendicular pain and is diagnosed as appendicitis, he goes to the hospital, he has an operation, he stays for 3-4 days, he comes back home. Same with cancer. In cancer, you have to stay less. Sometimes you go home the day after cancer surgery, like in breast cancer. You go home the very next day. The only thing is you have to take some medicines or some other treatment for about 3 or 4 months or so. And then life carries on as usual. You're back to your normal activities, your normal routine. Nothing much changes apart from the regular checkups that you have to undergo. And the fear remains. A person who has had cancer once, I see patients coming back on follow-up after 5 years. After 10 years also. And I keep on telling them that you don't have to, because you've crossed 5 years, you have to come only once a year. People who have crossed 10 years, I tell them, you have crossed 10 years, please don't come. There is no need. Don't come. You don't have to come anymore. But they insist, we will come.
Okay.
We have to come. So there is a fear. And you know what's the strange thing about this fear? People are very brave during the treatment. I mean, the bravest part is when they're undergoing the treatment. And the fear sets in when they've gone back to normal life, normal work, and they have to come back for these follow-ups. That is when they are most scared. So this, you know, we have undergone we have done psychological studies about this. But cancer survivors live under a fear, which is really unnatural. But they do.
Okay, but that is a rare case. You're talking about patients who've already gone through a particular phase of this treatment. Now, yeah. I'm talking about people who have nothing. They're leading a normal life. But for them also, this topic is so dicey, they don't want to attend. Is it because of the guilt in their mind?
No, because now, let me give you a simile. Patients we know right now who have cancer, who need urgent treatment, otherwise the cancer will advance, are not coming for cancer treatment now during the pandemic. Fear, hospital jawana. So same fear, I won't have anything to do with cancer. I won't listen to it also. It's the fear.
Okay.
But actually you have to understand the disease. Then the fear goes. It is not something which is contagious. It is not something which is definitely going to kill you or maim you for life. It is something which is going to happen. You're going to get treated. It's going to be a period of 6 months. And then in 80% of cases, if you come early, you're going to carry on with life as usual.
Perfect. So let's get to the next topic which we want to understand. Or as a layman, I would like to also understand. Although Google tells us everything these days, but the Google does not tell us the easy part. The language is so difficult for anyone to understand that it really doesn't work. So, ekdam saral bhasha mein, ekdam easy Bengali, Hindi, English bhasha mein samjhaiye, what is cancer? Is it something like tumor that happens in the brains or somewhere that we see phoda jaise ho gaya?
Yeah. So, let me make it very, very clear to you what it is. We all have cuts in the body. Sharir mein cut ho jata hai kahin pe bhi, chot lag jata hai, cut ho jata hai chamde ke upar. So kya hota hai when there is an injury? The cut heals. So how does the cut heal? The cells from the surrounding part, they divide and they cover the wound and then the injury heals. So what happens? When there is an injury, somewhere in the body, there is a start signal, which tells that cells, you start dividing, there is an injury or a gap which you have to repair. So the start signal comes in the body automatically. Cells start dividing and the wound gets repaired. And then there is a stop signal, which says, okay, now stop. The wound is repaired. So this cellular division is in the body is a normal repair mechanism for which there is a start-stop signal. So imagine somewhere, anywhere in the body, sharir ke kahin bhi ho sakta hai. Breast mein ho sakta hai, brain mein ho sakta hai, lungs mein ho sakta hai. Without any reason, bina karan ke, ek start signal chalu ho gaya. There's a start signal. And in that place, usi jagah pe, the cells start dividing. And divide karke, ek pind banaya, ek lump. And the stop signal does not happen. So the cells go on dividing. और डिवाइड करते करते वो एक पिंड बना दिया, एक लंप. अभी उस लंप इज अ ट्यूमर. नाउ दिस ट्यूमर्स कैन हैपन एनीवेयर इन द बॉडी. वो चमड़े के ऊपर हो सकता है, जो हमारे यू नो मेनी पीपल हैव लंप्स ऑन द स्किन. देयर आर दिस मेनी यंग गर्ल्स हैव बेनाइन ब्रेस्ट लंप्स, सम पीपल हैव स्किन टैग्स. दीज आर ऑल ट्यूमर्स. Many ladies have fibroids in the uterus for which they undergo hysterectomy. Very common. Bleeding hota uterus mein kya hai? Fibroid hai. Hysterectomy ho gaya. So these are benign tumors. So the tumors can behave in two ways. The tumor can be a good boy and it can stay in the organ where it has started, not grow too much, not cause much of a problem. Like benign breast tumors, the skin tags or things like that.
Benign matlab?
Benign matlab, benign aadmi hai, achcha aadmi hai.
Harmless. You mean the harmless?
विनाइल इज हार्मलेस. जिस ऑर्गन में बना उसी ऑर्गन में रह गया. Does not go to any other organ. That's a benign tumor. It's a tumor, but it's a benign tumor. Very common. Everybody almost has something or the other in the body. Or this tumor can be a bad boy. It can ask its first of all, it can grow and grow and grow. And then it can ask its cells, ki chalo blood mein jao, lymphatic system mein jao. So its soldiers, its cells, think of its cells as the soldiers. They will go through the blood, through the lymph, to other organs of the body, like the liver, the lungs, and set up colonies over there. They'll divide, set up colonies. Ek se ho jayega 10, 10 se ho jayega 100. And they will destroy that organ. So that is a malignant tumor. Malignant means harmful. Harmful tumor. So cancer is a synonym for a malignant tumor. Harmful tumor जो अपना सेल्स को ब्लड में छोड़ देता है कि जाओ शरीर के और जगह जाके बैठ के कॉज डिजीज डिस्ट्रॉय दैट ऑर्गन डिस्ट्रॉय ऑल द ऑर्गन्स दैट इज कैंसर एंड गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग इन इट्स ओन एरिया एंड डिस्ट्रॉइंग द ऑर्गन्स अराउंड इट बाय डायरेक्ट स्प्रेड बाय ग्रोथ दैट इज अ कैंसर. वेरी सिंपली पुट दिस इज बेनाइन ट्यूमर एंड दिस इज कैंसर.
सो डॉक्टर साहब ধরুন আমাদের শরীরের মধ্যে we have so many organs inside. As a normal human being, how do I come to know that there is some problem in some part of my organ and I need to approach for a particular test, which is for cancer test? That's the last thing that comes in our minds unless we actually start feeling too much of pain or too much of something, is it?
Yeah. So cancer, the initial signs and symptoms of any cancer just like any other normal disease. So, apne jo upar tak talab bhi aashan, agar aap upar se niche tak gaye, so if you start with the mouth, because it's oral cancer is very common. Any ulcer or sore in the mouth which is not healing, it may be in the tongue, it may be in the gums, it may be between the teeth, it may be upar in the palate. Any ulcer or something which is not healing, any sore throat which is persisting for more than a month, hoarseness of voice, gala baith gaya, gala boshe gache, is not getting well. Gargle, chargle chal raha, it is not getting well. Time to go visit an ENT consultant. Blood from anywhere in the body, blood in the sputum, blood in the calf, blood in the stool, blood in the urine, blood from the nose, abnormal bleeding in women, after menopause ke baad wapas bleeding chalu ho gaya. Anywhere blood which is abnormal, difficulty in swallowing, any indigestion which is not theek, gas, commonest complaint, gas hoyche, gas ho, antacid chali raha hai, treatment chali raha hai, gas theek nahi ho raha hai, which is basically acidity or indigestion which is not getting well. Jaundice. For ladies, any abnormal sensation during periods, any bleeding, excessive bleeding, less bleeding, anything out of the ordinary during the periods, any lump in the breast or lump in the armpit, which is painless, painful bhi ho sakta, but usually painless. Nobody can remember so many things, right? Not possible for a layman. So all the symptoms of cancer are basically like normal things. So the thing to remember is that any symptom which is out of the ordinary, jo normal treatment dawai se nahi theek ho raha hai, to jaake doctor dikhana chahiye. Aur most important thing to remember is usually kaun doctor first dekhta hai, the general physician first dekhta hai. Suppose oral cancer, GP will see first or dentist will see first. He will send to an ENT guy or a maxillofacial guy. And then it will come to us. So when you go to a GP, suppose for oral cancer, breast mein kya hota hai? Pain hota hai breast mein ya lump hota hai. So lady goes to the gynecologist. The gynecologist should ideally refer to us. So kabhi kabhi kya hota hai? Usi jagah pe treatment atak jata hai. Kyunki test wahan pe nahi hota hai. So what the thing I am trying to get across इज एनी सिम्टम आउट ऑफ द ऑर्डिनरी, जो चल रहा है ठीक नहीं हो रहा है, डॉक्टर के पास जाना है, डॉक्टर ने दवा दिया या जो भी किया उसके बाद भी ठीक नहीं हो रहा है, इंसिस्ट ऑन इन्वेस्टिगेशन कि नहीं मेरा एसिडिटी ठीक नहीं हो रहा है तो मुझे एंडोस्कोपी चाहिए, मेरा स्टूल में ब्लीडिंग आ रहा है, आई बीन डॉक्टर इज गिव ट्रीटिंग और वेर एवर द पेशेंट हैज गॉन, मे बी ऑल्टरनेटिव मेडिसिन ऑल्सो मोस्ट वेरी कॉमन, पाइल्स बोल के उसका ट्रीटमेंट चल रहा है, एक महीना दो महीना तीन महीना चल छह महीना तक चल रहा है, लेकिन किसी ने कोलोनोस्कोपी नहीं बोला है, अगर गैस्ट्रोएंटरोलॉजिस्ट के पास जाता तो वो बोलता। सो द थिंग इज एनी सिम्टम आउट ऑफ द ऑर्डिनरी सी वन डॉक्टर सी टू डॉक्टर सी थ्री डॉक्टर अगर ठीक नहीं हो रहा है एंड इंसिस्ट ऑन इन्वेस्टिगेशन कि मुझे टेस्ट कराइए, देन ओनली द कैंसर विल गेट डिटेक्टेड। एंड आई एम टेलिंग यू of all the solid tumors in the body, all of them if detected in stage 1 and 2, agar aisa aaj ho gaya duniya mein ki sare cancer hamare paas stage 1 ya 2 mein aa gaye hain to 80 to 90% of cancers will be cured, a lot okay. of them without chemotherapy.
So stage 1 and stage 2, what is the gap between stage 1 2 and 3? I mean just now you said like we go to the physician first and he does treatments, he gives us medicines. So we are waiting for 3 months to realize it's not curing. So after 3 months, are we shifting from one stage to the other, or it's like there's some more time it needs to go to the stage okay. two or three?
So first, let me tell you what stage is.
Okay.
मैंने आपको क्या बोला था? एक start signal आया, cells start dividing, एक pind बन जाता है, वो pind धीरे-धीरे बड़ा होता है, फिर वो soldier को बोलता है जाके दूसरे organ पे जाओ। अभी cancer is not one disease. हर एक कैंसर, ब्रेस्ट कैंसर बोलिए कि लंग कैंसर, एवरी कैंसर इज अ डिफरेंट डिजीज। क्यों? क्योंकि जो क्वेश्चन आपने किया कि स्टेज वन से स्टेज टू में कितना में व्हाट्स द टाइम टेकन, दैट वैरीज फ्रॉम ईच कैंसर। सो ईच कैंसर बिहेव्स इन अ डिफरेंट वे। इरफान खान हैड न्यूरोएंडोक्राइन ट्यूमर, ही डाइड फ्रॉम इट। नाउ न्यूरोएंडोक्राइन ट्यूमर इटसेल्फ हैज थ्री वैरायटीज। Type 1 neuroendocrine tumor, even with spread all over the body, patient lives for 10 years. Whereas the grade 3 or high grade neuroendocrine carcinoma, which Irfan had, has a very high mortality rate. You got me? So even within one type of cancer, neuroendocrine cancer, there are three types which behave in three different ways. So there is no straight answer to this question, but stage kya hai, main bata raha hu. Jab ye chota hai, पिंड बन गया, पिंड जब छोटा है और उसी ऑर्गन में है, ब्रेस्ट का एग्जांपल लीजिए, वेरी कॉमन लेडीज के लिए, ब्रेस्ट के अंदर एक लंप जो हाथ में लग रहा है, पेन नहीं हो रहा है या थोड़ा थोड़ा पेन हो रहा है, हाथ में फील हो रहा है, छोटा सा है, मोस्ट लेडीज डोंट पिक अप एट दैट स्टेज, लेस देन 2 सेंटीमीटर स्टेज 1। अभी वो धीरे धीरे बड़ा होता है, फिर वो ब्रेस्ट से जाके आर्मपिट में चला जाता है, ये नीचे मसल को पकड़ लेता है, स्किन से फूट के आ जाता है, फिर फैलता है, then it spreads. So this progression we have arbitrarily divided into 4 stages. So when it is less than 2 centimeter, it is stage 1. Between 2 to 5 centimeter is stage 2. But both are early. Then जब वो फूट के बाहर आ जाता है और goes and involves the muscles here, then it is stage 3, which we call locally advanced cancer, but not spread. And when it goes to other organs, then it is stage 4. और मेटास्टेटिक, इसको बोलता है मेटास्टेटिक ब्रेस्ट कैंसर। तो 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2 अर्ली, 3 लोकली एडवांस, लेकिन दूर नहीं फैला है, एंड स्टेज 4 जब फैल गया है। अभी 1 से 2 में कितने दिन में जाएगा? 2, कैंसर इज स्लोली प्रोग्रेसिव डिजीज, 1 से 2 और 2 से 3 जाने में महीनों लग जाते हैं।
So let's recap the whole thing. As you said that our body gives us symptoms. We have something is wrong, we know, but it's not curing. It's continuing to remain there. It could be even a throat. It could be anywhere in the body. So, but our body continues to give us signals. That's the time we should think that let us go for further investigation.
A nagging problem which is not getting well.
So it can come out in normal investigations like we have to go inside. Any investigation where we go inside the body to understand, if there is anything wrong. And then they guide us to the right doctor. Am I right, Doctor, sir?
Yeah. So it depends. Like, suppose which part you are having the problem? There is no one single test which you can undergo, a screening test or cancer nikalega. There's nothing like that. You can undergo whole body CT scan also, it may not come out. Because if it's a small 2 centimeter ulcer in the mouth, stage 1 oral cancer, it won't come in the CT scan. It won't come in the PET scan also.
And no blood test can tell you.
No blood test can tell you. So you should undergo your annual health checkup. Because that covers broadly, roughly, bahut kuch nikal jata hai. If there's something majorly wrong. But small early cancer, you have to depend on yourself. Ki mera ye problem theek nahi ho raha hai. That can be bleeding in the from somewhere. Or that can be a chronic cough. Or that can be a mouth ulcer. But ye theek nahi ho raha hai. Don't give it more than 2 weeks time to see a doctor. And the doctor, and if it's not getting well, after seeing the doctor, insist on investigation. कि नहीं मैं जो आप और कई स्पेशलिस्ट को रेफर करिए या टेस्ट कराइए, then we'll pick all of them up early. People tend to ignore the fear. Again, we come back to fear. People tend to ignore. Go to the doctor. Doctor advises investigation. और डर के मारे they don't do the investigations. And then they come in stage 3. And that's where the problem is.
Okay, I get it. Now, suppose we go to another topic. Now, most important topic which I have noticed, I'm being very honest with you, Dr. Saab, that a lot of these patients, when they feel that there is some cancer problem, they rush to Bombay or they go to Singapore or some other place where they want to get a cure. Why? Are the facilities not good or satisfactory in Calcutta, or is it something else? What is the reason?
See, when I came back to Calcutta from Bombay in 2003, in the whole of Calcutta, there was no private cancer setup. The only semi-private cancer setup was in Thakurpukur. I'm just giving you the change which has happened over the years. I'm trying to explain to you. The machine which is used to give radiotherapy is called linear accelerator. When I came back to Kolkata from Bombay, 2002, there were no linear accelerators, private or government. Today, there are private cancer setups, Tata, Apollo, HCG, Co, NH. There are 7 or 8 private cancer setups, and there are more than 20 linear accelerators in the city. With 12 more in the pipeline, had this pandemic not happened, by the end of this year, there would have been 12 more. So equipment-wise, it's same. Now it's same, it wasn't. But as anything, when change happens, the time taken for that information to percolate to everybody, to the public, takes time because perceptions remain. So equipment-wise, it's same. Now take, for example, in my hospital, the medical oncologists, are 3 of them, are all from AIIMS, New Delhi. I'm from TMH, Mumbai. My junior colleagues are either from Rajiv Gandhi or trained in USA. Nobody's trained in Kolkata. So the chaps who are manning these cancer hospitals in the city, none of them are actually trained in Kolkata. So training wise also, you have people who have come from the same places where people are rushing to for treatment. Like I tell my patient that had you gone to Bombay today, had I stayed on in Bombay and not come back, I would be treating you in Bombay. Or I would have treated you in Bombay when patients come back with treatment. The same people I worked with in TMH are now the seniors over there. And we all know each other by name. As Kavita said, there's an Indian Association of Surgical Oncology, and there's an 8-member body which governs the whole thing. And I am the Eastern Zonal representative. So we all, you know, it's a small group. It's not like you're going to get something in Bombay or Chennai, which you're not getting, because we all talk the same thing. We meet every month. We discuss the same issues. We see the same videos. We practice the same surgeries. So it's a perception difference, which will take time. But yeah, there was a huge gap even 10 years ago. But now it's not there.
So you mean to say, standard-wise, they are the same. And cost-wise, you think you are at par with all of them or somewhere up and down?
Yeah. So cost-wise, it would vary. So, for example, South is very cheap. Mumbai is very expensive. Unless you're going to TMH. TMH is a government. Unlike most people who believe that Tata Memorial Hospital, Mumbai belongs to the Tatas, it doesn't. TMH, Mumbai, Tata Memorial Hospital, Mumbai is a central government hospital. Directly under the Atomic Energy Commission, under the Prime Minister's office. It has nothing whatsoever to do with Tata Medical Center in Kolkata, which is a Tata hospital, like Jamshedpurka Tata Hospital. Okay. So TMH Mumbai being a government hospital is cheap, but the rest of Mumbai is very expensive. Kolkata, you have all spectrums. Apollo Cancer Hospital is expensive. TMH is a shade cheaper, but not too much. TMC, called Calcutta TMC, Tata Medical Center. Then there are cheaper cancer hospitals in Kolkata also. So in Kolkata, there are all ranges. In Bombay also, if you go, the rate in Lilavati is not the same as in Borivali.
True.
So there are all ranges. Depends on which hospital in Bombay you're going to. South as a whole, the rates are a little lower. But then the cancer treatment is not a one-day treatment. It's a six-month treatment. So add to that the cost of traveling to and fro and staying and going up and down and logistics. There was a time when the entire family could go and spend 6 months over there. Nowadays, work culture, where does the son have the time or leave from work to be with the father in Chennai for 6 months? So a lot of issues are there. But standard-wise, 10 years ago, what Calcutta was in cancer treatment and what it is today is the difference between an ambassador and a BMW. In cancer, I'm talking about. Only in cancer.
I think you are making a lot of sense because you see, most of these high-profile, like film actors or whoever, they have this issue. The first thing they do is they fly to US for their treatment.
I'll tell you a very funny thing. The actors fly to US. It depends. So the businessmen, they probably fly to Singapore. Correct me if I'm wrong. Right? From Mumbai. I'm not talking Calcutta. Rich people in Mumbai don't get treated in Mumbai. They go to USA. The bureaucrats, I mean, the politicians in Delhi or rich people in Mumbai, they go abroad. Our urban rich class and upper middle class goes to Bombay. Middle class, largely. A lot of them get treated over here also, but I'm seeing the general trend. The middle class goes to Tata Memorial Hospital, Mumbai or South. Entire Jharkhand, Northeast Bangladesh comes to us. So it's a, I think it's a mentality that my local thing is not good, so I must go out.
And you agree. And you have a record of 0.1%.
No, that is actually not the case. There's something called a surgical audit,
okay,
which measures that what is your complication rate and what is your mortality rate after surgery. The intro which was given to Kavita by our association said 0.1% failure rate. No. Yeah. If early cancers come to us, 80% cancers we can cure. That 0.1% is the mortality rate. The audit was done all India. Every surgeons and every organization's mortality and complication figures gets audited. So my mortality rate means the number of patients dying as a complication of cancer surgery is 0.1%, because cancer surgery is a very major surgery. It's not like your appendix or normal operation. So it's a high risk. Most of them are very high risk operations. So there the mortality rate is, I'm quite proud of it, that it's one of the lowest in the country. It's 0.1%. That does not mean that my failure rate means I'm curing 99.9% cancer patients. No, my operative success rate is 99.99%. My failure operative mortality rate is 1.1%.
Excellent. Very well explained, Dr. Saab. In fact, we hear a lot of these cancers. There are so many cancers. The entire body has the chance of getting cancer. But according to you, which is the most prevalent or the highest population of cancer in the organ-wise? Suppose we go oral cancer, we have breast cancer, then there are other cancers. According to you, which are the top four in terms of the maximum number of cancer patients?
See, across rural-urban divide, the commonest cancers in India are breast, oral cancer, lung, and cervical cancer in women. So in women, it would be breast and cervical. Men, it would be oral and lung, mostly because of habits. Very interesting thing. In northeast of India, all the northeast patients come to Calcutta for treatment. So they have a very high incidence of stomach cancer and esophagus cancer. That is also because of their food habits. Stomach cancer and esophagus cancer is also very high in Japan because their food habits are similar. It's about smoked and salted kaccha, sushi, salted fish, and they contain nitrates and salted food. So Northeast and Japan has the highest of stomach and food pipe cancer in the world. Mizoram has the highest incidence of stomach cancer in the world. And they all come to us. So we, the cancer surgeons of Eastern India, actually do the highest amount of stomach cancers in India. But that does not mean stomach cancer is as a whole very prevalent in India. It is site-specific. So for example, when we say breast cancer is prevalent all over India and rising, cases are rising. Oral cancer, also one of the four most top common cancers in India, is mostly in the Gangetic belt, the cow belt, as we call it, because of the habit of chewing tobacco. Jarda, Kheni, Supari, Panparag, Ranjini Ghanda, etc., etc., etc. Gutka, mostly being gutka. Cervical cancer is very common in women, but of the lower socioeconomic strata. Upper socioeconomic strata, it's breast. And lung in males as a whole is very common all over India.
So this cervical cancer, sorry, I interrupted.
No, carry on.
No, I was just asking, the cervical cancer, we've heard about this particular injection, which is it true or effective for a particular age?
See, why does cervical cancer happen?
Okay. Yeah.
Cervical cancer happen because of a virus, a very bad word today. Okay. So some cancers are caused by virus. That virus is called HPV, human papilloma virus. Not coronavirus, papilloma virus. That causes cervical cancer, that causes some cancers in the nose also. Nose and in the back of the mouth. These viruses infect a person during the act of kissing, in the case of nasopharyngeal cancer, or sexual intercourse. The man transmits to the woman. The man is asymptomatic carrier. Transmits to the woman. The woman, after being infected with HPV, only a small fraction of them will develop cervical cancer, and that also after many years. So mostly it is common in women of lower socioeconomic strata, where protection methods are not followed, or people who have multiple sexual partners. These ladies, they get affected with HPV, 16 and 18, two types are there. And some of them after 8 years get. Now, so being a virus, we have found a vaccine. It's taken years, but we have found a vaccine. So the vaccine, if you inject to girls before they reach the age of puberty, normally we say between 9 to 12, before a girl has had her first sexual encounter. Because even the first one can be the one communicating, you don't know. So before she's had her first sexual encounter, if the vaccine is given, it's not a be-all and end-all, it's not foolproof. But if this vaccination is given all across India, cervical cancer after 20 years will become very uncommon.
Okay, so
some cancers will still break through and cause it, in spite of the vaccine. There are types of cervical cancer which are not caused by HPV, but largely it will be insignificant.
So, and is the age limit you said is 9 to 12. What about women who have missed out on this age? Do they have a chance again to get the same injection or vaccine there?
They can take the vaccine. There is no harm in taking the vaccine, but how much it will, if they haven't yet been infected with HPV, the vaccine will work.
And any blood test that shows the HPV?
No.
Oh. So how do you know if it is HPV?
The pap smear.
Pap smear test. Okay.
The pap smear tells us the abnormal, whether the cells in the cervix are okay or not.
Okay.
If they are okay, then they are very... See, that those cells in the cervix which are tested by pap smear, na, they undergo a stage-by-stage transition to cancer over 8 years. Very slow. So even the stage before cancer, which is called CIN3, that will show on the pap smear. And even not all CIN3 patients will go to cancer. So cancer usually gives you a lot of time. Unlike what people believe, patients come to me with a diagnosis and say, sir, we want the operation tomorrow. ऐसा नहीं है उसको इन्वेस्टिगेट करना है देखना है ऑलरेडी कहीं फैल गया है कि नहीं व्हाट वी कॉल अ मेटास्टेटिक वर्कअप वेदर इट हैज ऑलरेडी स्प्रेड और नॉट वी हैव टू जज द पेशेंट हिज फिटनेस एटसेट्रा लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स बिफोर वी सब्जेक्ट द पेशेंट टू सर्जरी बिकॉज अदरवाइज द सर्जरी वोंट बेनिफिट हिम तो कैंसर गिव्स यू अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम इट डज नॉट प्रोग्रेस लाइक द व्हर्लविंड सम कैंसर्स डू बट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द मेजॉरिटी ओवर हियर दे डोंट गो लाइक अ व्हर्लविंड
Perfect.
What time did that work?
Okay. So, talking about cervical cancer, we have an option to take care of through the pap smear test, and we can eliminate by taking the injection, the vaccine, as you suggested.
Yeah.
Now, as we move further, the second most important part of the organ which suffers with cancer, as you said, is the breast cancer. Let's talk about this particular cancer, as to how should one move as he feels that there is a lump in the breast, that she finds out there's a lump in the breast. So what should she move and how should she act on it? And you suggest on that, sir.
Okay, so let's first talk about what breast complaints ladies have and they come with.
Yes.
90% of women who come to us come with the symptom of pain. Breast mein darad ho raha hai, pain ho raha hai. And they typically describe the pain as radiating to the arm or going to the back from the breast. It is very common. Now, this is called fibroadenosis or fibrocystic disease. It's a normal sensitivity of the breast to the woman's daily hormonal change, monthly hormonal changes. Some women are more susceptible to the hormonal changes and feel some pain with the change in the hormones along the month. And the breast structurally, 1 in 10 normal women have this fibrocystic disease. And the mostly they
Is the audio okay with others?
No, there is a bandwidth issue at Dr. Gupta's end.
You are going off the audio sometimes for a second or two.
Yeah.
There is a band.
Are you okay now?
Yeah, it's okay, but in between, majhe chole jacche.
Okay. I've changed my connection to another connection.
Please go ahead.
This should be better.
Yeah.
Okay, meanwhile, he changes the connection. Let's talk about tomorrow. We have a session on parenting by a very good speaker. He is coming in from Pune. His name is Narendra Godiani. Narendra Godiani, and he's amazingly good, a very good orator, and he will discuss about the issues relating to parents. Parenting, rather. You can a live session when your mistakes are highlighted hugely. Anyways, and Sunday we have a session with Dr. Rajiv Agarwal. He's going to talk about motherhood, his bliss. Doctor, are we there?
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Perfect. Better.
Okay. So, many women come with a complaint of pain. Okay. Now, that pain per se is not cancer. Many women, What I want to get across is that many women have pain in the breast, and most of them are not cancer, but pain is happening, so they must go to the doctor, to the gynecologist or to somebody like us, and get it self-checked. So every woman must undergo a monthly...
There is an issue. I think, again, aapne offer gaya, sir.
Breast self-examination.
Can everybody go? Can everybody switch off their videos? Let's try this now, because bandwidth is being an issue there.
Videos request. Are all switched off only.
All are switched off, yeah?
Yeah, yeah, almost.
Okay. Dr. Saab, you can continue. Dr. Saab, kahan chale gaye?
No, he's there, but bandwidth issue. His video is frozen.
Yeah, his signal is low.
Signal is low, and that's the reason it's...
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. You changed to the next signal.
No, I did not. Yeah. Okay. So, many women have pain in the breast, but that per se is not cancer. But still, they should get it checked. Cancer is when you have a painless lump in the breast. Something you feel like when you're bathing or something. It just hits your hand. It's a painless lump, like an egg or maybe smaller than that. Or a lump in the armpit. If there is pain, chances are less it is cancer, but still it needs to be checked. So when every lady needs to undergo a breast self-examination, stand in front of the mirror and do a breast self-examination every month. It's very easy. It's learned on YouTube. Once a year, you need to go and see a doctor. That's part of your routine health checkup. Every year, a woman goes for a well women check or annual checkup, and there's somebody is going to examine you, and that's where, you know, a clinical examination gets done. So most of the breast cancers, 95% of the breast cancers will be found out this way, because either they'll find it themselves, or if they diligently do an annual health checkup, because mammography and sonography are part of that annual health checkup, so it will come up. And once it comes up that, you know, there's a small lump. Nowadays, you know, Jiten, ladies are coming to us with lumps, with breast cancer, which you can't even feel. It's a new impalpable breast cancer, because women are so conscious nowadays, they're going for mammography and sonography routinely. And so they're coming with 1 centimeter small breast cancers, which you can't feel, but you can see on the mammography and sonography. And those are 100% curable without chemotherapy, without radiotherapy, just by a 1-day surgery. She gets admitted in the morning, surgery, she goes home next day. Baat khatam. Maybe she has to have a tablet for 5 years. So it's all about the detection rate. So once sonomammo, there's a lump found, then the further things happens like FNAC and everything. The treatment starts.
Okay, I get it. Next, what? After that, suppose somebody feels that there is a lump, and then they go for mammography. Okhane dhora jacche je kichu ache. So then what? What should be the next step? How? What should they act? What is your suggestion to them?
When there is a lump on mammography, or a lump is felt and mammography and sonography confirms, jahan lump hai, lump pache. Then some tissue has to be taken from that lump and seen under the microscope. The procedure is called a biopsy. The process of taking koyekta cell okhan theke ber korte hobe. Kuch cells ya tissue wahan se nikalna hai aur microscope ke niche dekhna hai. So, or a core needle biopsy. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me? Yeah.
Yes. Can hear you.
So it is.
Maje slow hai jache, but theek ache. Chhod de, mere upay nahi. No, I just. Apna je room ta ache, their signal may be low. You can move around and talk also.
No, actually, I am on 3 connections.
Apni je to bol le na, biopsy is again another some. There is a say on that, biopsy, yeah. Barcode, it spreads, but kichu ate kichu ache. Fear of biopsy is also.
There's a very, there's a very prevalent misconception.
Okay.
There's a superstition ki biopsy ko le chhodiye jaye. And you know what? I've been in Tata Memorial from Bombay for so many years. And patients used to come from all over India to us. Tikkina. Only patients who came from Eastern India had this belief ki biopsy ko le chhodiye jaye. You wouldn't believe it. a patient from Kashmir or a patient from Tamil Nadu or a patient from Andhra hasn't even heard of it. Ki biopsy korle choriye jaye. It is only the Bengali and the Odia and the Bihari patients who would come and say, "Sab biopsy karne se to fail jayega." Somehow there is this prevalent misconception in this part of India ki biopsy korle choriye jaye. Maybe it is historical ki आगे हो आजकल की है nowadays what we do is before doing an operation we scan the whole body to see कि कोनो spread नहीं and then we do the surgery. There was a time कि cancer है doctors used to operate straight away even 10-15 years ago. Spread was there but the checkup was not done. So biopsy होय छे operation होय छे and then 3 months later spread is detected. So the connection was made the spread is because of surgery or biopsy. But biopsy or surgery does not lead to spread of cancer. Biopsy is the main investigation. Biopsy, if biopsy is not done, then the cancer is not proven. And if the cancer is not proven, then the treatment does not begin. And all over the world, biopsy is done with a needle, small needle, very thin needle. It is done by the interventional radiologist. It's called a core needle biopsy. Be it the breast, anywhere else, the biopsy is taken. It is proven. Now, एक बार अगर प्रूव हो गया कि ओके देर इज कैंसर टिश्यू इज टेकन फ्रॉम दैट क्लंप माइक्रोस्कोप के नीचे डाला गया पैथोलॉजिस्ट देखा बोला कि हाँ कैंसर है. अभी नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज स्टेज क्या है. स्टेज के ऊपर सब कुछ है. सो फॉर स्टेज एक तो हाथ से देखना है जहां पे इट्स विजिबल लाइक इन द ओरल कैविटी और इन द ब्रेस्ट. But elsewhere in the body, it is not. You can't examine the tumor. So it's a scan. You have to undergo a whole body scan, which will tell you locally how big is the tumor and whether it has gone anywhere else. If it has gone elsewhere, then it is bad. Then it is stage 4. Then you cannot cure the patient. Then surgery is not done. Patient goes for medical treatment. Like chemotherapy, targeted therapy, gene therapy, various types of medical treatment are available now. But if there is no spread, then it is either stage 1, 2, or 3. Is it clear till now?
Yes.
4 means spread. 4 means no surgery, no point, because it is already everywhere. एक नेबरहुड में सबको कोरोना वायरस हो गया तो एक को आइसोलेट करके फायदा नहीं है. Stage 4. स्टेज 1 और 2 इज एक फैमिली में एक आदमी एक फैमिली में दो आदमी को कोरोना वायरस है तो उसको आइसोलेट करो. सो स्टेज 1 और 2 फर्स्ट गेट द डैम थिंग आउट ऑफ द बॉडी. सर्जरी मेन ट्रीटमेंट. ओके नाउ पॉसिबिलिटी इज दैट इवन स्टेज 1 और 2 सम सेल्स मे बी सर्कुलेटिंग इन द ब्लड. सो आफ्टर सर्जरी व्हेन द रिपोर्ट कम्स. Suppose breast. Nowadays, mostly in breast cancer, we don't remove the breast. We do a breast conserving surgery with oncoplasty, maintaining the shape and size of the breast. यहाँ पे भी एक गलत फहमी है लोगों में कि breast निकालने से पूरा निकालने से cure हो जाने का chance better है. 40-year-old, 45-year-old women come to me with stage 1 breast cancer and tell me remove the whole breast. It is absolutely not required. So they need to undergo something called a breast conservation surgery or breast oncoplasty. Breast bacha ke, uska size, shape, form bacha ke surgery karna hai. Breast is very important to a lady psychologically. Jab cancer diagnosed ho jata hai, then they're in panic, then they want everything out. 10 years down the line, they regret, why did we get the breast removed? So jisko breast bachana possible hai, it is as safe. So I'm just veered from the topic, sorry. So. Stage 1 and 2, stage 1 and 2, pehle get it out. Nikalne ke baad jo bhi niklega, nowadays we don't always remove the nodes from the axilla also. There's special technique called sentinel lymph node biopsy, which is done by only us in Eastern India, whereby we can spare sometimes the axillary clearance also. That way the woman doesn't have all those arm issues. Sometimes you see breast cancer ladies, heart itna phula hua hai, wo sab, all those things are things of the past now with this new technologies. Breast chala gaya, haath phula hua, aajkal wo nahi hota hai with the latest techniques. So operation ho gaya, next day patient ghar chala gaya. Do hafte baad wo report aaya, sare jitna bhi whatever we removed comes in the 5-page report, details of the tumor. उसके हिसाब से हम ये डिसाइड करते हैं कि ठीक है चलो ट्यूमर तो निकल गया, लेकिन इज देयर एनी चांस ऑफ सेल्स सर्कुलेटिंग इन द ब्लड? अगर चांस है कि सेल्स सर्कुलेट करना कर रहे हैं ब्लड में, देन दो सेल्स हैव टू बी किल्ड इन द ब्लड ओनली बिफोर दे गेट अ चांस टू सेटल डाउन एनीवेयर. दैट इज वेयर द मेडिकल ट्रीटमेंट एडिशनल कम्स इन, विच इज कॉल्ड कीमोथेरेपी और टारगेटेड थेरेपी. नाउअडेज हार्मोन थेरेपी, मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ थेरेपी आर देयर. कौन सा लगेगा, फॉर हाउ मच, विच वन, वेदर वन और टू और इन अर्ली कैंसर नन. अर्ली कैंसर वी डोंट गिव एनीथिंग ऑल्सो. सो दैट इज डिसाइडेड एंड दैट टेक्स 4 months. एंड देन इफ द पेशेंट अंडरगोज ब्रेस्ट कंजर्वेशन सर्जरी, ज्यादातर हम लोग आजकल ब्रेस्ट कंजर्वेशन ही कर रहे हैं, देन देयर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी कि चलो ब्रेस्ट का तो ट्यूमर निकाल दिया, ब्रेस्ट बचा क्या कर दिया, लेकिन ब्रेस्ट के और कहीं में द अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द ब्रेस्ट इफ देयर आर एनी सेल्स लिंगरिंग, हो सकता है पॉसिबिलिटी इज देयर, मे बी नॉट ऑफ दैट कैंसर बट न्यू कैंसर्स आर डेवलपिंग इन द रेस्ट ऑफ द ब्रेस्ट. समटाइम्स देयर आर मल्टीसेंट्रिक ब्रेस्ट कैंसर्स, ब्रेस्ट के चारों क्वाड्रेंट में यू नो डिफरेंट एरियाज दे आर कमिंग. So radiation to the breast. So that's radiotherapy. So there are mainly 3 bullets against cancer. Surgery, systemic therapy means medicines, be it chemotherapy, be it targeted therapy, be it hormone therapy, be it gene therapy, medicines. Third, radiotherapy, which is basically X-ray. Patient ko aana hai hospital mein, ek X-ray karna hai, chale jana hai. That goes on for 5 days a week. For 5 weeks. For breast, it is nothing, just like a sunburn. But for head neck cancer patients, it is quite painful. But for breast radiation, they don't even feel. They always complain about the fact, these five weeks, we can't take a full shower. That is what troubles them the most. So, ho gaya. Surgery, 4 weeks medical treatment, then radiation, in five months, 4 months medical treatment, 1 month. 5 months, treatment is over. She's back to normal life. If she's had chemotherapy, the bal will not be there. The hair will be totally gone. But the hair always also totally comes back. Chemotherapy, not all types of chemotherapy take the hair away, but most do. But the hair always comes back. That is also certain. So for breast cancer, if it's stage 1 and 2, stage 1, only surgery, no chemotherapy, in most cases, radiation. Stage 2, थोड़ा सा बड़ा हो गया लेकिन कन्फाइंड है, अगेन ब्रेस्ट कंजर्वेशन सर्जरी, केमोथेरेपी और टारगेटेड थेरेपी एंड रेडिएशन. स्टेज 4 सर्जरी करके फायदा नहीं है, सारे जगह चला गया, सो ओनली मेडिकल ट्रीटमेंट. स्टेज थ्री ऑल कैंसर, स्टेज 3 मींस लोकली एडवांस्ड, तो इमीडिएटली ऑपरेबल नहीं, उसको छोटा करना है, छोटा करके ऑपरेट करना है. So in stage 3 of all cancer, stage 3 is what we get very commonly in India. Pehla chemo deke usko chota karna hai, phir surgery karna hai, phir radiation dena hai. So this is more or less the pattern followed for all cancers.
Okay, Dr. Saab, incidentally, we have one patient here who has had this issue. Neema Vipani, are you there? Neema Seth?
Yeah, I think I'm there.
Okay, hi Neema, how are you?
Bas fine.
This is a very interesting topic, actually. So many things we are learning from Dr. Shoykot. Dr. Shoykot, she is a very good friend of mine, a school friend. So I just saw her and I invited her to say hello to you.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Hello.
To you.
So tell hello. Us about yeah. yourself.
Can you see me now?
Yeah, I can see you. Yeah.
I want to hear about you, what you went through, what happened, your experience, because there's such a relevant topic here. Maybe you can throw some light.
Please do.
What Dr. Sir said is absolutely right. Cancer is more people. It kills people more of because of fear instead of actual cancer. That is the basic truth, what he spoke about, you know. And when I was detected, I was stage 1. And immediately I got myself operated, even in the stage 1. And then it's almost 4 years down the line that I'm fine and absolutely work normal.
That's See, she's the nice. Classic example.
Yes, that's
she
right.
She had a stage one disease and she's completely back to normal. I mean, it is...
Absolutely. And as you said, sir, that it takes about 4 or 5 months. And after that, and I had a tremendous family support in which they never let me feel that I should be, you know, like having a... that I am detected with cancer and I should be, you know, left alone or something like that. I got a tremendous support from my family. They were there with me at each and every step. And there was no question of any depression or anything. In fact, I was absolutely, I took it in the stride that whatever has come will always go one day. And this is life. So things will come and you have to lead your life.
Thank you, Nima. Thank you so much. A great feedback. Dr. Saab, I just barged in because I just saw her in the list and I pulled her in. I'm sorry about this.
You did a great thing. I should more of, you know, other people should also, if there are any survivors or anybody in the group, they should come forward and talk. Because you see, what she said is exactly it. And she was detected in stage one. So stage one is almost assured. I assume it was breast cancer. It's almost assured cure. So you have to go through the damn thing, the treatment for 6 months. Okay. But you know what the funny thing is in that 6 months, the only hospitalization is for the surgery. And that is also 2 nights, less than your appendix operation. You go home the day after surgery. Even if you need chemo, it's only day care. You come, you sit in a chair like this, recliner, and you take the chemo and you go away. After 4 hours, and radiation is just a daily X-ray. So for breast cancer, the treatment has actually come down to a very low traumatic level for the patient. Not so for all cancers, I'm afraid. For example, oral cancer, which is another very prevalent cancer.
Before we go to the next subject, we have some, there are some questions lined up.
Absolutely.
Avitaji, would you please read out the questions, please?
Yes, sure. So the first question, for patients who have recovered from ALL and are normal over 5 to 10 years, what are the chances of relapse and what periodic tests should be done to keep track?
Okay. So ALL stands for acute lymphocytic leukemia. That is actually outside the ambit of this chat because that is treated by a hemato-oncologist, not by a surgical oncologist like me. Like Jiten, I think, put it on the chat thing that this is not everything except brain tumors and blood cancers. This is a blood cancer, but still I'll answer the question. I presume this person, whoever has the ALL is under the care of a very good hemato-oncologist. So the even 5 to 10 years later, the chance of relapse is minimal. ALL, acute lymphocytic leukemia, is a one of out of the leukemias, it's a very curable disease. I know people who are adults now, my age, who have had ALL in childhood. I know quite a few of them. And as far as the tests which have to be done, that I would advise this layer, the person who's asking the question, to go by the advice of the hemato-oncologist who's treating him or her.
Lovely. Next question, please.
Okay, thank you. A painless wart has developed on arm and neck. It's growing bigger. What is it and can it be removed?
Yeah, so that is a very important point. There is a cancer called melanoma. And melanoma is a very bad cancer. It develops in the what we call as nevi, moles. A lot of us have moles in the body which we call beauty spots. Now, if a beauty spot has been there since childhood and is not changing in color, appearance, size, then it's a true beauty spot and there's nothing to worry about it. But if there's a new beauty spot which has suddenly come, a new nevi or mole, or an old mole is changing appearance, growing in size, suddenly starts itching, suddenly becomes a little inflamed, or starts bleeding, then that is a chance of being melanoma. So any mole, which is any beauty spot, which is new and growing a little bit too fast for your liking, it's bothering you, or an old mole or a new mole, whatever, which is causing bleeding, itching, needs to be removed. Needs to be removed and biopsied, because there is, even that it's not sure it's melanoma, but it can be melanoma, and you don't want to take a chance. Because again, if there's a small melanoma and it's completely and properly surgically removed, you don't need to do anything after that. No chemo, no radiation, nothing. But that same melanoma, if it comes in stage 3 or 4, there is no cure for it. So cancer has it gives you all the choices at first and the option of a completely non-traumatic treatment. But the same cancer, few months down the line, will take heaven and earth to treat and still not get cured.
Good going, doctor. You are already one hour into the session. All caring, Kichu.
No, I'm fine. I've got this tea, which is cold, okay. I think. Anyway, no problem.
Next question, Kavita.
Yes. Yeah. There used to be a message that a ABC drink, apple, beetroot, carrot, was good to prevent cancer. Is it true or fake?
Well, apple will keep the doctor away. Apple, beetroot and carrot juice. See, there's a lot of stuff going around about what you should have, preventive antioxidants. The only one which has scientific evidence, as in the basis of trials and cleared internationally, is haldi. There is evidence for turmeric. There is no evidence as yet for anything else. But as you know, our ancient Ayurveda, there's a lot of stuff which has yet to be subjected to
testing. Apna awaaz to chule gaya
uska. Muted by the host.
So
haldi is good. I myself have haldi every morning. But this apple, beetroot, carrot juice is good. Having lasun is good. Other antioxidants like chole, etc., you know, sprouts is good. But if you ask me scientific evidence as preventive, haldi has.
So haldi, what quantity? Mane 100-200 gram roj khena ho nahi?
100-200 gram roj haldi chibiye khena ben.
Jigish ko chi emni? For knowledge sake.
I don't know. I have to ask my staff how much they give me. They give me a little bit of haldi.
I make notes every day. I started with no page. Now I'm sitting at page number 100. Every doctor comes, right?
A little bit of haldi. Haldi, kacha haldi.
Achha, kacha haldi. Roj. We should have kacha haldi roj, yeah. Subah morning, right?
Subah morning, yeah. It's good. It has antioxidant properties.
Okay. Next question, Kavita ji.
Yes. Next question is there a direct proven correlation between tobacco and cancer?
Yes, of course. There is a direct proven relation between tobacco and many cancers. But let me tell you how this proven correlation works. For example, a smoker has 2.5 times the chance of developing lung cancer than a non-smoker. So it's not like if you smoke, you will get cancer, or if you're you will get lung cancer, or if you're a non-smoker, you won't get lung cancer. It doesn't work like that. It's statistical, which means that they have taken, say, studied 10,000 lung cancer patients and seen how many of them were smokers and how many of them were not. And this epidemiological data shows that there is a 2.5 times increased incidence of lung cancer among smokers. But there's a direct relation between oral tobacco, which is gutkha, khaini, pan, and oral cancer. It's absolutely direct. There is a direct relationship between smoking and lung cancer, throat cancer, bladder cancer, pancreatic cancer. There is a relationship between food pipe cancer and smoking and alcohol together, Jitin. Okay. Smoking and alcohol done together has a direct correlation with food pipe cancer. But these are all epidemiological data, but we largely believe them to be true. And one of the prime directives we give to everybody is to quit tobacco in every form.
Okay, so the tobacco leads to cancer, that's for sure. Now, you mean
tobacco
to say...
Tobacco leads to cancer for sure.
That's for sure.
Means not all tobacco users will get cancer.
Two and a half times of normal, you said.
Yeah, your risk increases by 2.5 times more than a non-smoker. Than a non-smoker, assuming the environment is not polluted. Now, if you're living in Kolkata, then maybe it's, I don't know, maybe it's 1.5 times more, maybe it's 2 times more, but it's more. Because atmospheric pollution also...
I received a message in the morning from somebody saying that I used to have cigarettes and I quit cigarettes, quit smoking 10 years back. What are the chances of me getting cancer? Can you hear me? Dr. Saab, can you hear me?
Is my connection slow?
Yeah, you're there.
I'm just changing my connection to something else. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, better.
Yeah, so I've changed again my internet connection.
So I received a message from someone that he quit smoking 10 years ago and he hasn't touched cigarette after that. What are the chances of him getting cancer?
Hello?
Yeah, can you hear me?
He quit smoking 10 years ago. Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, yeah.
He quit smoking 10 years ago.
Yes.
What are his chances of cancer? So after a person quits smoking, his chances of not getting cancer comes back to that of a non-smoker after 15 years. So after 5 years, his chance of will be the same as a non-smoker.
Okay. And if someone has smoked only for a little while, say 1 year, 2 years, what are the chances of him getting it? How much time of smoking you think is bad for his lungs to get cancer?
We call it pack years. So it's related to a lot of things. It's not just the duration of smoking, but also the number of cigarettes smoked per day, the strength of inhalation, whether the filtered, non-filtered part has no significance. So the pack years, number of packs into number of years, aisa calculation hai. So a person has just smoked for 1 to 2 years, then the chance is less. It's almost the same as a non-smoker. It is only after you have smoked for a decade or more. But then to come back to the chance of not developing cancer, you have to, you know, be a non-smoker for 15 years.
Okay.
Your risk stays even after you quit, but the risk keeps on decreasing.
Very good. Next question, Kavita ji.
Yes. A person taking Pan Bahar and Zalda for many years, chances of malignancy is more. How can it be detected? If found positive, what will be the procedure of treatment?
See, what happens in people who take Pan Parag and Jarda for many years is before cancer develops, something called oral submucous fibrosis develops. It's a very big word. Okay. So
there is a polling happening for you, doctor, about the session and majority are saying excellent.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah. So far, 93% have said excellent for you. Wow, 94%. Good going. Please do the polling.
Thank you.
It's a report card for you, actually. The question was set by us. So you answer the question, you get your report card.
Thank you. Report card kharab hota to nahi dikhana na.
So far, you got 95%. Huh?
So far, I'm doing good. Yeah.
Only 1% said good. Rest have all said excellent.
Program is in stage 1. 90%... more than 90% recovery. Stage 1 cancer. So for people who have that oral tobacco, first, you know, the oral mucosa lining undergoes some changes. Wo safed safed wala, lal lal wala change aa jata hai. Isko bolta hai leukoplakia. Typically, jahan pe wo rakhta hai na, that every person keeps his wad in a particular place. Differs with everybody. And that the both sides, the insides of the cheek become red and white. Usko bolte hai leukoplakia. Then gradually, you will notice in many people, they can't open their mouth very big. That is because the entire lining becomes very tight. Hard ho jata hai. The entire inner mucosal lining. Usko bolta hai submucous fibrosis. Mucosa is our lining. Submucous is the layer below the mucus. Fibrosis means tight. सो जो म्यूकस लेयर है उसके नीचे का जो लेयर है वो सफल होता है इसलिए हम मुंह खोल पाते हैं, वो टाइट हो जाते हैं इसलिए खोल नहीं पाते. सो ओरल सब म्यूकस फाइब्रोसिस हो जाते हैं. सो ऑलमोस्ट ऑल लाइक ऑलमोस्ट ऑल स्मोकर्स इफ दे स्मोक फॉर एन एडिक्वेट नंबर ऑफ इयर्स विल गेट सीओपीडी फॉर श्योर, बट ओनली अ फ्रैक्शन विल गेट कैंसर. सो हियर ऑल्सो ऑल ओरल टबैको यूजर्स फॉर श्योर विल गेट ओरल सब म्यूकस फाइब्रोसिस एंड ल्यूकोप्लेकिया, बट अ फ्रैक्शन ऑफ देम विल गेट कैंसर, बट अ लार्जर फ्रैक्शन, बिकॉज द प्रोग्रेशन फ्रॉम ल्यूकोप्लेकिया एंड ओरल सब म्यूकस फाइब्रोसिस टू कैंसर इज वेरी हाई. सो अगर सब म्यूकस फाइब्रोसिस तक चला गया, मुंह खोल नहीं पा रहे और यू नो लाल लाल हो गया अंदर, देन चांसेस ऑफ डेवलपिंग कैंसर इज वेरी हाई. सबसे बड़ा प्रॉब्लम है कि इसको ठीक भी नहीं किया जा सकता, दैट माउथ ओपनिंग कैनॉट बी इंक्रीज. देयर हैव बीन मेनी थिंग्स डिवाइस फ्रॉम सर्जरी टू लेजर टू मेनी थिंग्स, बट होता नहीं है. इट इम्प्रूव्स फॉर अ व्हाइल एंड अगेन गोज बैक. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ओपन योर माउथ वेल एंड ईट योर फूड, फॉरगेट कैंसर, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू एंजॉय योर फूड, गेट द टेस्ट and be able to open your mouth, please stop using oral tobacco. Well, that applies to paan, supari, jarda, the whole gamut. Not too soft. Some people ask me, can I have soft, you know, mori. Mori is okay, chewing gum is okay, but not the other stuff.
Okay, I had this question directly coming in from my SMS right now. I'm reading it out. Hi Jitin, I follow your shows regularly. I want to ask a question. I'm seeing you live on Facebook. You're live being watched in London by this person. Wow. He says, I have a major issue. I lost my very close friend to cancer. After that, I have lost my senses. I keep feeling that I have got some disease or the other. I am scared that I keep going to doctors to get myself checked up and trying to eliminate that I have a cancer from this organ to the other organ. I'm married, I have a child, I have my own business, but I cannot give that time. In the last 7 months, 8 months, I'm literally out of my mind. Should we call it hypochondria? Dr. Saab, are you there?
Yeah, can you hear me? Yeah, can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now. You heard the question?
Yeah, yeah. He lost a dear friend to cancer, and since then, he's been having this fear that he also will have cancer. And you remember Jiten in the show, just the previous show, where
yes, there was lifestyles of doctors. Yes, yes.
I told you the same thing.
Yes.
That there are these people who come back to me and they have this inherent fear of cancer and they come back, you know, every 2-3 months and say, check up.
He says he does not go to a cancer doctor. He keeps going to all of the doctors to eliminate the chance of having a cancer in
He does not want to go to a doctor.
No, he does not want to go to a cancer specialist.
Let me change my connection.
Yeah, please.
No, he doesn't have to go to a cancer specialist. Let me change my connection and see if things get better. Is it better now? Can you hear me?
Yeah, ek to halo ar ki mota moti cholche apna signal ta.
He has an issue, but the issue is not cancer. He definitely has an issue. And I would advise him to seek some counseling first. You know, that's very important. Because maybe Dr. Ram or somebody like that can help him.
No, psychiatrist. Oh, yeah, he's written.
Yeah.
He's written the message.
I also did
a psychiatrist. He gave me medicines. But then I'm not comfortable. I know I have no problem mentally. I think I keep looking.
You should undergo an annual health checkup and go on, stop visiting doctors and go visit a doctor only if there's an issue.
Problem, yeah.
Only if there's a definite symptom. Only for the fear of cancer, he should not go on visiting doctors. One second.
we have somebody watching from Australia. Manish, how are you? We have kept you on mute. I'll call you over. Wait, I'll call you over. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, Manish, how are you? Let me unmute you first. Yeah, hi Manish, how are you?
Good, man, good.
So what time is it in Australia now?
It's almost 12. I was actually following you on Facebook because I didn't get the link before. I just found the link and I said, let me join in. I had one question.
Yeah, please.
With regard to my dad. See, my dad in 2012, he used to smoke before quite a bit. But in 2012, he got some sort of a mild growth in his throat. So we got an operation done for him in Bangalore. And then he became okay. But what happened was the doctor said that since it was in the vocal cord with the change in season, his voice goes like, you know, the speech goes down. So up to about 6 months back, everything was fine. I mean, we accepted it. But last 6 months, you know, his voice has gone like pretty down and he's shown it to the doctor again. And the doctor is saying like he's around about 84, 85. He said, see, there's a slight growth again. Because last time when they checked, they said it was not malignant. But now he says, you know, there's a slight growth again. He says, again, we want to do laser or not do laser. He's saying the age factor is there. So my father is a little skeptical. He said, Nana, just avoid it. But what is happening is his voice is deteriorating. I mean, you can nowadays, you know, most of the time you can hardly hear him. So I was just wondering what's the go with that? I mean, is there any remedy, solution? Because they tried to give him steroids and all that. Didn't work quite a bit.
Doctor, aap to chha gaya, doctor. Aap koi London se khoj raha hai, koi Australia se khoj raha hai. You become a hero. Good, man. So, see the serious question from Manish from Australia.
Yeah, Manish. I take it he had voice box cancer, like laryngeal cancer, right?
No, he didn't have a cancer, doctor. It was a slight growth, which they did laser and they removed it in Bangalore.
And he had an ML scopy and laser surgery.
Laser. He had a laser.
Laser surgery. And now he has another growth and they are suspecting
again, they suspect there's a slight growth again because that happened in 2012 and now it's around about 2020. So he went last year towards the end or I think January this year and he went and got another test done. And in the test, they found that there was a slight growth again. But the doctor advised against surgery. He said now he, because of the age factor, not to bother too much with it. They tried to give it the stereo the first time. They gave him steroids. It helped him quite a bit. And his voice became absolutely normal. But the second time they've given him steroids has not actually helped him quite a lot.
Is he up and about? Is he physically fit?
He's fit in the sense only he's got a slight back problem. Other than that, he's fit. I mean,
he's up and about the house and all that.
Yes.
And his only problem is hoarseness of voice.
It's not hoarseness. His voice, like literally, you know, it like goes off. Like, you know, you can hardly speak. And sometimes you have a throat problem, you can hardly speak. It becomes like that. Initially, it used to be happening with the change of weather. Now it is like sort of, you know, it's sort of becoming permanent last 6 months.
And it doesn't have difficulty in breathing, does he?
No. Nothing of that. Nothing else. No other issues other than the normal little high sugar, little high blood pressure. Other than that, no other issues. He's pretty fit.
So see, Manish, looking at this logically, there are two things this can be. One, it is the same benign growth which was there first time it was removed by laser surgery.
Yeah.
Or possibility number two, this can be cancer, right? These are the only two possibilities.
Yeah.
Now, if it's that benign growth, if you again undergo laser surgery to remove the benign growth, his voice will become worse.
Yeah. Okay.
Steroids and things like that is working to a certain extent. So, as if it's benign, she really should just stay at home. Since she has no difficulty in breathing, sometimes voice is going, you should...
Oh, আপনার ভয়েসটা চলে গেল সাহেব আপনার ভয়েসটা চলে গেল শুনতে পাচ্ছি না
this problem happens with zoom you know it's like it keeps fluctuating
no actually the weather is such it's raining now
oh okay we are also having very high winds today that's why I'm connecting over the phone
yeah doctor sir apnar voice ta chole gechilo we could not hear
okay
now it's better yeah in between chole gechilo yeah
till where did you hear manish
So you said it's benign growth. If it's benign growth, then it'll become worse if he tries to do a laser. Yeah.
If we do laser, so just give him the steroids and accept the little bit of voice ka issue and take it like that. The other possibility it is cancer, in which case it'll become worse and it'll block his airway and he won't be able to breathe. So that needs to be treated not by surgery at that age but by radiation, because it's an early disease. So but how do you know if it's benign or cancer?
Because the first time when they took the sample and they tested, they said no, it's clear, it's not cancerous. They had done a little bit of they took the tissue and they did a biopsy on that.
Yeah.
This time when it again happened, so he went to I think a doctor called Dr. Kundu, a Dr. Guptu in Lifeline.
Okay. And so was a biopsy done?
No, the second time they didn't do a biopsy. What he said was to go down to either to Tata Oncology in that in bypass to either go there. Otherwise, he said, don't bother about it. He said, at this age, don't touch it. Theek ache, it's there. You can scrape it off. I can do a scrape. But I wouldn't want to touch him at this age. That's what the doctor himself said. So he gave him some medication. Last time also, doctor had given him some medication. His voice had become absolutely okay. But this time, the medication has not actually worked quite a bit. So what is happening is not that, his voice is like sort of, it's very low. He can't, hear him quite a bit. But he doesn't have, any pain or anything.
Manish, can I request you, if you, Dr. Sahib, allow, I'll give him your number. He can give you a WhatsApp call and take your opinion.
Sure.
Manish, I'll give you a number. You can call him up because there are so many other people waiting.
Absolutely. I'm sorry. Yes, absolutely.
Thank you for being there, Manish. Just hold on. Don't go. Okay, doctor, we'll go run through the question answer quick now, like rapid fire. You try to answer in one word, two word, or one line. Okay. Which food can be having carcinogenic effect and should be avoided?
Well, avoid steamed and salted food. Raw fish, the sushi, don't have too much sushi. My advice, we don't have steamed food. Yeah, don't have too much sushi. Every other bit of cooked food is fine. Avoid raw, avoid red meat as much as possible. So food-wise, have lots of fish and fresh vegetables. Avoid red meat because red meat has a tendency to cause colon cancer, and avoid sushi, that kind of steamed or semi-raw or salted food.
Perfect. Anything related to weight? Cancer with weight connection, is there? Yeah.
There is a relation between weight and cancer. Obesity. Why do you think breast cancer is going up in urban Indian women? We are following the West. As our lives are getting more westernized, obesity is also increasing. Our diet is changing, our activities are changing, traditional ways of life are going. So we are getting the diseases of the West. Breast cancer, ovarian cancer are both directly related to obesity. But again, that does not mean thin women will not get breast cancer. See, these are all statistics. They are playable things. So obesity and cancer has a link, but that does not mean that all obese people will have ladies will have breast cancer and thin women will not.
It's
very general. But yeah, obesity, avoid obesity is a message, if you ask me as a cancer specialist.
Good. Does consuming alkaline water decrease the chance of cancer?
No.
Next question. There's a theory one comes across, cancer is nothing but a deficiency of vitamin B17. Is it true or false?
False.
Good. Lovely. A person taking, fine. So these are simple questions. There's another one. Is it generic? Is genetic? Genetic.
Yes, some cancers are genetic. Ovarian, breast and colon cancer are genetic, of the common cancers. There are many, but of the common cancers, if your direct family member has had breast, ovary or colon cancer, then you should go to a doctor, a specialized doctor, and seek his opinion as to what additional tests you should have every year in your annual health package.
Good. Does hysterectomy and HRT intake increase chances of cancer anywhere in the body?
Hysterectomy does not increase your chance of cancer anywhere in the body. Hormone replacement therapy, many ladies who have gone treatment for infertility, IVF, etc., the chance of breast cancer increases. But again, it's a statistical thing. Only a fraction of ladies who have undergone HRT will develop breast cancer, which can be directly linked to that HRT and not to anything else. But it marginally increases your risk.
Okay. Interesting question coming from somebody who does not want to leave pan. He says, pan without tobacco, is it still harmful?
Just the bitter leaf?
Yes.
It is.
It is harmful. भाई छोड़ दो पान छोड़ दो पान छोड़ दो
ओके okay. तो शादी में जाके एक पान जो हम लेते हैं वो ठीक है
ओके शादी अब तो आई नो दिस द सेकंड दिस नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज लिटिल लॉन्ग द आंसर विल बी लॉन्ग बट ट्राई टू मेक इट शॉर्ट बिकॉज़ यू आर ऑलरेडी 1 आवर एंड 32 मिनट्स इनटू द सेशन आई डोंट नो हाउ मच यू आर एंजॉयिंग बट आई एम वरीड अबाउट यू
आई एम फाइन ओके आई एम यूज्ड टू डूइंग 5 आवर सर्जरीज स्टैंडिंग अप एंड नाउअडेज विद पीपीई सो बिलीव मी आई एम कंफर्टेबल
What is the procedure of treatment for oral cancer? Now, this is a long question.
So, oral cancer, the primary treatment is surgery and radiation. Chemotherapy has very limited role. So, again, let us come back to the classroom of that stage 1, 2, 3, 4. So, one is a very small oral cancer. So, very small surgery required. Plastic surgery reconstruction usually not required. Radiation usually not required. Patient gets away with surgery alone. And very, very high cure rate, near 100%. Stage 2 is it is confined to the mouth, but pretty big. So there you need a major surgery. But pehle jo concepts the ki mukh bigda, ekdam chehra bigad jayega, ekdam kharab dikhne mein ho jayega, kha nahi paunga, bol nahi paunga. All those are gone, not because of the cancer surgeons, but because of the plastic surgeons. So in my days in Tata Memorial, we used to remove the cancer and then the plastic surgeons used to come and do the reconstruction, but a very crude reconstruction, taking muscle and skin from here. Nowadays, with the new microvascular reconstruction techniques, they are so good that when we take out the jawbone, part of it, or whole of it, and inner part, they can do such a good job reconstructing that the structural and functional outcome, which basically in lay terms means how well you speak and eat, is near normal. You know, I have a month ago removed the entire tongue of a patient, and my plastic surgical team has taken tissue from the thigh and reconstructed the tongue so well, Jiten, I'll make that person stand in front of you, open his mouth. You won't be able to say that's not his tongue, although he can't move it. But when you hear him speak, it'll be better speech, much better speech than what Manish's father is speaking. It'll be intelligible over the phone, a person whose entire tongue has been taken out. So stage 2 requires a major surgery, major reconstruction, this one. Major reconstruction, 15 days in the hospital, not funny, not enjoyable, but still cure rates are 60% to 70%, but the patient has to have radiotherapy after that as additional treatment. Stage 2 gaya. Stage 3 is when the cancer is really locally advanced, fungating out, like what we used to see back in those days in TMH in 2002-03, or still village people come like that, you know, huge ones. Cure rate very low, 30%. They're usually so big that to remove so much, the plastic surgeon throws up his hand and says, boss, I can't reconstruct this. Tum jitna nikaloge, wo hum reconstruct nahi kar payenge. To usko chota karna padta hai. To stage 3 mein pehla chemotherapy deke usko chota karna hai. Chota karke, phir, you know, it comes to a manageable stage where, you know, what I remove, the plastic surgeon can reconstruct. But the structural and functional outcome, talking, speaking is not so good. And patient requires both chemotherapy and radiotherapy after surgery. So stage 3, low maximum treatment, maximum trauma, poor outcome. Stage four is when it has gone to other areas, like neck mein kuch bada sa node aa gaya, fixed, lung mein chala gaya. Out of my ambit, surgery ka koi role nahi hai, because it is no longer locally there. Cure rate zero, because you can save nobody. The medical oncologist treats with chemotherapy and palliative treatment and symptomatic treatment for as long as required, but it's not good. So again, the trick is to catch them young in one and maximum two. One may sabko cure kar sakta hai, almost. Two may 80% ko cure kar sakta hai. And how do I catch them in one and two? If the patient himself, you know, catches it at one and two and goes and gets the test done and reports early. So it pays to be a little bit of a hypochondriac to get bothered with small symptoms and go and seek medical treatment than being the brave one, ki mera kuch nahi hoga, nothing's happened to me.
Okay. You've answered so beautifully. We actually, the subject is too big, but you've gone short and explained quite a lot on this. Now, we are left with three topics. I would like you to complete it fast because your time is precious. Hum to aise bhi vehle hain. Another one is, what are the healthy lifestyle tips you want to give to your listeners? I mean, what they should adapt in their lifestyle so that they are, at least the chances of having cancer in their life is reduced.
Okay, it's a 6 or 7 point thing. Number one.
Yeah.
Avoid tobacco in all forms. Number two, alcohol in moderation. Number three, half an hour of exercise every day. Must. Lots of fresh fruit, fresh food, green leafy vegetables, fish and chicken for the non-veg. Avoid red meat. Avoid smoked and salted non-veg food. Not salted by chanachur, nahi bol raha. Salted fish, yes, salted meat, yes, steamed fish and steamed meat. Avoid number of multiple sexual partners for women or unprotected sex. Vaccine, cervical cancer vaccine for the young girls. Annual health checkup. Be a hypochondriac. Seek medical investigation for the smallest of symptoms. And be more aware of your body, less scared of cancer, because if you catch it in one, you'll get rid of it with the minimum of it.
Okay, so very well explained, actually. The next one, which is very much more interesting, is what is your message to all of us, as in the fear and everything. The topic that we had today was fear kills more than cancer. So what message would you like to give all of us?
The fear is multifactorial. See, the fear is of the disease. Fear is, main bachunga ki nahi. The fear is of the treatment more than the disease. How traumatic will my treatment be? And the treatment, and the fear is also financial. Because what I say is, when a cancer attacks a person, it doesn't attack the person. It attacks the family, because the family suffers with the patient. Not only the family can't share in the physical suffering, but the mental suffering and the financial suffering they undergo. So my message is the same. Adopt this healthy lifestyles. Be more conscious of simple things which are going wrong. Seek early medical treatment. Because if you catch them in stage one and two, neither are your finances it. You are getting away with simple treatment, most likely with surgery alone. Maximum little bit of radiation will avoid the most toxic part, which is chemotherapy. So those six tips, along with seek medical attention. Because for stage one cancer, your treatment is like a bariatric surgery or a gallbladder or a appendix. I mean, maybe a little more than that, but nothing very traumatic.
Perfect. Very well explained. The entire thing about cancer is so strong, but you dealt it so beautifully. Dr. Saab, thank you so much. perhaps it's because of your personality. You are such a wonderful personality and pleasing person to talk to.
Thank you so much.
How do you remain so fit? What do you do? You do your workouts or what? You are into some special physical exercise?
I am into exercise. I work out 5 days a week. And on Sunday, only Sunday I go to the gym in the club. And other days I work out at home. 3 days of normal workout, half an hour to 1 hour every morning. And twice a week I do martial arts.
Oh my God. Martial arts means which field?
Krav Maga. It's an Israeli martial art. It's actually a combat technique called Krav Maga. If you Google it, you'll find it. It's actually the deadliest martial art in the world. So I do that twice a week, 3 days of normal yoga or exercise. And on Sunday, I hit the gym.
So then why do you need this martial art? To combat with who? Dr. Mahendra or something? At the polo?
No, but mostly at home.
Only you need at home. And what about your children, Dr. Sir? You have kids? How old are
you? I have one son who's studying, who's in third year of law, studying in Delhi.
Okay. And he is with you now or he's in Delhi?
Yeah, now he's with me because of, you know, the situation. But normally he is here only on vacations. So he's in OP Jindal, the university in Delhi. He's studying law over there, Jindal University.
Okay. Well, I would like to flash your number or somebody's number if they want to connect with you for further questions or they want to come in.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Whose number would you like to give, sir?
You can take down for appointment. It would be if somebody wants an appointment, not that I would. That would be my secretary's number. That would be 98301-35904. And my personal number is 98311-75819.
I hope nobody from Papa Jesse talk show has to ever call him up for this. But
I always tell my patients. You know, whenever I go to a social gathering, people introduce me to a doctor. You know, he's a doctor, he's a surgeon, and then they tell them, but he's not a surgeon you want to go to. You know, I tell them that I want to meet. I tell all my friends that I want to meet you only socially, never professionally, because I know what happens. Because I see so many patients. You know, like I told in your show the other day. That I see people, 30, 40 patients, maybe if I see in a day on my clinic day, I see people walk into my chamber whose lives were completely normal just 7 days ago. Just 7 days ago, you know, they were just like me. And then some small issue happened. They went to the doctor, got some investigation done, endoscopy done, this done, that done, FNAC done. And then suddenly it's the big C. And the world is upside down. It should not be upside down because all this, the talk that you have just had, is to create the impression that it's not the end of life. It is just another disease which will go away in 6 months. Just have to get it treated. But for people, it's a big C. So life is upside down and they're in complete year. So I know what people face when they get diagnosed and what goes through the thought of the whole patient and family. So that's why I tell people only socially, not professionally.
Perfect. My friend. Thank you so much, Dr. Saad. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you, Manish, all the way from Australia. And thank you, Nimi. Nima, where are you there? Are you there? Okay. Chalo, thank you so much. Thank you, friends. Thank you, Ravi. Thank you, Manoj. Thank you, Kavita. Nima, you are there. Nima, you're there. You are on mute. I'll just unmute you. 1 minute. Yeah, you're unmuted. Thank you so much, Nima.
Most welcome. But sir, it was wonderful. How he easily explained everything. It was too good.
Thank you, Nima. Thank you.
Thank you, Nima, for being there. Thank you, Dr. Sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Have you here, sir.
It was a very interesting show. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye, everybody. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.